My comment is not as long and personal as everyone else. I've only been here a few times, but I just have to say that I know that a wonderful, gracious person as Virginia, you know, people oscillate to her, but there's been such a tremendous random act of kindness that I see with not just Virginia, but with all of the people that live here. And I hope everyone feels that, because as an observer, and I am, I'm a private investigator, so I observe, that's what I do. And I just see all the people that care, they really care here. And it's a very loving environment, and who could actually really want more? You have friendship, and you have good caregivers. And it's a blessing. And happy birthday, Virginia. I love you.
Does anybody else like to have something to say to Mr. Junior before we move forward? Anybody else? Well, if not, then I'd like to share this very brief thing with you all. Oftentimes on Mondays, some time ago, we used to have Bible study on Mondays. We still do it now. Miss Glory is so precious. She does Bible study on Mondays. But when I was doing Bible studies on Mondays, sometimes we would do just, we would take some time just to give expressions of thanks to God for all the witnesses' kindness. And whatever we felt in that moment in time would be the thing that we all would take time to individually share for our moments of thanksgiving was. And those were very special times. And during one of those sessions, we did that, and then we broke out in song, and I think it was Miss O'Reen who led us in Amazing Grace. And we sang Amazing Grace, and we were all blessed by it. And after the song had been sang, Miss Virginia, it was Miss Virginia's turn to say what her faith, to share Thanksgiving with us. And Miss Virginia said that that song had summed it all up, that it said it all. And so, having remembered that, and Miss Doreen is so precious, Miss Gloria's going to sing it, and I'm going to hold the microphone for Miss Doreen, and Miss Doreen and Miss Gloria is going to salute Miss Virginia with the song Amazing Grace that she herself said was a testimony of her life. And if we had something tangible, if I could touch something tangible that represented grace, it would be when I touched Miss Virginia.
Amen.
She is the epitome of love and grace and just wonderfulness. If God wanted us to see what love was, he sent us Virginia so that we could see something tangible, something notable, something that we could say we saw, something that we could say we touched, and we knew that love was real. And Miss Virginia, we are not simply saying this, and I speak this for everyone, but we're not simply saying this because you are here at this moment and we have to say something good. We're doing this because you are good, and it gives us a privilege to be able to try to give back to you, to show you what your goodness has given to us. I remember and the story, and you know, Miss Virginia, that you shared with me long, long time ago about your father and when you took him back home and he found the shotgun over the door frame, I forget what you call it,
The door frame.
Okay. And I remember you told me that story, and I remember how touched I was by your act of love to make sure that your father finally got a chance to go back home. And I thought what a wonderful daughter you must have been. Yeah. And by your own life and your own sharing, Miss Virginia, you have given testimony to that goodness and graciousness, and the act of kindness really does continue to grow. So whenever God shall choose that we've had enough of you, he shall take you back for himself. You would have left a legacy of love and grace and kindness, and we appreciate that. Having said that, Ms. Gloria and Ms. Irene is going to salute you in your own testimony, Amazing Grace.